Good morning, children. Welcome back to our math session. So we are continue studying division. I think all of you are by heart the multiplication tables and did lot of division problems. It's very important. Learn very well. Okay. So we starting our today's class. Today we are going to study division of 3-digit and 4-digit. Division of 3-digit and 3-digit and 4-digit number by 10 or 100. 10 or 100. Okay. So division of 3-digit or 4-digit numbers by 10 or 100. First of all, we are going to study division of numbers by 10. So how we are dividing a number by 10? Just listen. Okay, when a number is divided by 10, the remainder will be the digit in the ones place of the number. The remainder will be the number, will be the digit in the ones place of the number. Reminder, ones place of the number. Okay. And the quotient will be a number with the remaining digits of the number. The quotient will be a number with the remaining digits of the number. It's very simple. Just listen. When a number is divided by 10, the remainder will be the digit in the ones place of the number, and quotient will be a number with the remaining digits of the number. Okay, one example. Look at one example. Okay, 536 divided by 10. Okay, 10, we are dividing this number by 10. So what will be the remainder? Remainder, we know that we are writing R is equal to, Q is equal to. First of all, we are finding remainder. Okay, so remainder will be the digit in the ones place. Which is the ones place here? 6 is the ones place number. So, this number is, we take it as a remainder. Okay, this is 6 is, take it as our remainder. And the remaining digits, what are the remaining digits? That is 513, that is 53. To take it that number as the quotient. 53 as quotient. So ones place digit as the remainder, and the remaining digits will be the quotient. That's it. Okay, very simple. So we go through some questions. Listen, find the quotient and remainder. In the quotient and remainder. First question is here. First question, 445 divided by 10. So, what will be the remainder? Remainder will be the digits in the ones place. Okay, what will be the quotient? The remaining digits. Remaining digits means that 44. That is quotient. Isn't it? Symbol. Okay, so we can write it as quotient is equal to 44 and remainder is equal to 5. That's all. Next, again a number, a 3-digit number by 10. So remainder will be the ones place number, ones place digit, that is 4. And quotient is the remaining digits, that is 69. Okay, so we can write it as Q is equal to 69 and R is equal to 4. Very simple. Then 840 divided by 10. Here look at the ones place digit, that is 0. So 0 is the remainder, and the remaining digits 84, that is the quotient. Q is equal to 84 and R is equal to 0. Again, another question, 700 divided by 10. Here, 0, that is remainder, and the remaining digit is 70 is the quotient. Q is equal to 70 and R is equal to, remainder is equal to 0. Okay, all these four questions are three-digit numbers. So, what happened when four-digit number comes? The same thing. It's the same thing when we divide a four-digit number by 10. You have to take the ones place digit as the remainder. Okay, ones place digit as the remainder here. 5 is the remainder, and the remaining digit 634, that is the quotient. Okay, so listen. Q is equal to 634 and R remainder is equal to 5. It's very simple. How many zeros you take it, that much of number as the remainder from the ones place. Okay. Next question. 10 and 4320. The same way, ones place digit as the remainder, and the remaining digits 432 as the quotient. Quotient is equal to 432, remainder is equal to 0. So, okay. So you have to take the ones place digit of that number as the remainder, and the remaining set of numbers as the quotient. That is same in the case of the 3-digit number and 4-digit numbers. Okay. Now, we are going to study when a number is divided by 100. Earlier we studied a number is divided by 10. Here we are going to study number is divided by 100. So, 400, two zeros are there. What will be the remainder? The remainder will be the digits in the ones and tens place of the number. The remainder will be the ones and tens place of the number. Two zeros are there, so you have to take two digits from the ones place. Okay, so we take ones and tens place. And the quotient, what will be the quotient? Quotient will be a number with the remaining digits of the number. Okay, remaining digits, that will be the quotient. Okay. We are doing some questions. Find the quotient and the remainder. Quotient and the remainder. Okay. First question, 3-digit number, divide that by 100. So, tens and ones place number, you have to take it as a remainder. So, here 3 and A, you take these two numbers. This is ones place number. This is tens place number. This is the ones place number and this is the tens place number. You take both of the numbers together because you are doing division by 100. So here we have two zeros. So you have to take two numbers. Okay, 38. That is the remainder. And the remaining digit, that is 9. You take that number as the quotient. So quotient is equal to 9 and remainder is equal to 38. Again, 3-digit number, 100 divided by 100. The last two numbers, ones place and tens place numbers, take it as remainder. And the remaining digit 6 is, take it as the quotient. Q is equal to 6 and R is equal to 73. Next one is a 4-digit number. Listen, here we have 2 divided division by 100. Two numbers from the ones place and tens place. 37, take it that number as the remainder, and the remaining digits, that is 29. 29 is the remaining digit, take that number as the quotient. Understood? So Q is equal to 29 and R is equal to 37. So a 4 digit number, we have quotient 2 digit and remainder 2 digit. Okay. So very simple one. Again, 7000 divided by 100. Take the last 2 digit, that is as remainder, and the remaining digits, take it as quotient. Okay. So Q is equal to 70 and R is equal to 00 means 0. R is equal to 0, remainder is equal to 0. Okay. So it's a very simple division. You have to just keep in mind that how many places you have to take it as remainder and how you have to take it as a quotient. So these are the numbers, how to divide numbers by 100 and 10. It's very simple, isn't it? Okay. So we going to the word problems. Look at question number 1. 48 pencils are to be packed equally in 6 boxes. How many pencils will be there in each box? Okay. So 48 pencils to be packed equally in 6 boxes. Equally packed in 6 boxes, and how many pencils will be there in each box? Here, each box. In each box, which operation we will do? Lot of things are given to you. You have to find the value of 1. Okay. So what operation we will do? We will do division. Okay. So 48. How many pencils are to be packed in 6 boxes? 48 pencils and 6 boxes. So we are in a third standard. You have to write down the steps. Not in MCQ. When you are writing the notes, write down the steps. We need here 3 steps. Okay. So how many pencils are here? 48 pencils. A total 48 pencils are there. So you have to write down the first step as total number of pencils. Total number of pencils 48. Then how many boxes? We have 6 boxes. So you write down the step as number of boxes is equal to 6. So what we have to find out? How many pencils will be there in each box? So you have to write down the step as number of pencils in each box. How will we find out that? You have to divide the number of pencils divided by number of boxes. Okay. So isn't number of pencils 48? Then what is the operation? Division and divide by 6. So how will we find out the answer? Doing division. Or you have to simply tell the table of 6 and reach up to 48. Okay. So when will we get 48 in 6 table? Yes. In 8. 6 8s are 48. So the answer is 8. And you will have to write down what will we find here. We found the number of pencils. So write down 8 pencils. Write down 8 pencils. Understood? Okay, next question. 3 lollipops were distributed among some children. If each children got 5 lollipops, how many children were there? 35 lollipops were distributed among some children. If each children got 5 lollipops, how many children were there? Okay. So here we given here the total number of how many lollipops are there. So what will be the first step? Total number of lollipops. Total lollipops. That's equal to how many? 35. And each child got 5 lollipops. So number of lollipops each child gets is equal to 5. So how many children were there? You have to find out how many children were there. So you have to divide these two numbers. That means total number of lollipops and number of lollipops each child get. You have to divide these two numbers. Then you will get number of how many children were there. Okay. So our third step is number of children is equal to total number of lollipops, that is 35, divided by number of lollipops each child get, that is 5. Then what will we do? You have to tell the table of 5 and reach up to 35. So in fifth table, which number into 5 is equal to 35? Yes, 7 into 5. 7 5s are 35. So you have to write down that 7 as our answer and write down children. We here find out number of children. So 35 divided by 5 is equal to 7. That much of children. Write down this one. Okay. Now, next question. 125 students are to be seated in 5 rows. Then how many students will be seated in each row? So 125 students seated in 5 rows. How many students will be seated in each row? So first of all, we are writing total number of students. Okay, total students is equal to 125. And the number of rows, that's equal to 5. And number of students in each row. How will we find it? You have to divide this 125, divide by 5. Then we get number of students in each row. Okay. So 125 is a big number. We will divide it here. 125 divided by 5. How will we divide? Take the first number, that is 1, that is smaller than 5, you take the next number also, number became 12, and tell the table of 5, and reach up to 10, means reach up to 12, or just less than 12 in the table of 5. So here, 1 5 is 5, and 2 5s are 10, 3 5s are 15, so it exceeds 12. So we will take 5 2s are 10, write down 2 in the quotient, and write down 10 here and subtract it 2 and write down this 5 also because 2 is smaller than 5. So here we are telling table of 5, we get 5 5s are 25. So our answer is 25. Okay, so how many students in each row? 25 students. Okay, we did the division there and then we have to write down the answer like this. 125 then divide by 5 is equal to what will we get? Well, got which answer we got? 25 was the answer and you have to write number of students. So write down 25 students. Okay, so this is next question. There are 72 students in a hall. Okay, 72 students in a hall. How many 4-seater benches will be required to make them sit in equal numbers? How many 4-seater benches? 4-seater benches will be required to make them sit in equal numbers. Okay, so here also we are doing division. So how many students are there? 72. So you'd have to write down the step as total students, that is equal to 72. How many four-seater benches? So in a bench, how many seats are there? In one bench, how many seats? Four seats are there. Okay, so number of seats in one bench is equal to 4. And what will we have to find out? We have to find how many four-seater benches will be required to make them sit in equal numbers. So, number of benches, you have to find out how many benches we need to sit them equally. So, you have to divide that two numbers. That means total students, 72, number of four-seater, number of seats in one bench, that is 4. So, 72 divided by 4 is equal to, what will be get the answer? Divide it. 72 divided by 4. 1 4 is 4, 2 4s are 8. That 4, 8 exceeds 7. So we will take 1 4s are 4. Then subtract these two numbers, 7 minus 4, that is 3, that is smaller than 4. So bring down that 2 here. So then 32 is bigger than 4. Tell the table of 4 and reach up to 32. In the table of 4, 8 4s are 32. So our answer is 18. Write down the answer. Okay. Write down the answer. That is 18. And write down number of benches we find out. So 18 benches. Okay. So this much of things we have to study in division part. So today we studied division of a number, 3-digit and 4-digit number by 10 or 100, and then some word problems based on division. Okay, so you have to study, I already told you, study the multiplication tables very well. Otherwise, it's very difficult to find out these answers. So, learn very well. Okay, so this is our class. For today's class, I am winding up the class, okay, and this is my number. If you have any doubt, call me. Thank you.